ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांध्यज्ञानांजना शलाकया चक्षुरोन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांता स्वामिनीति नामिनी। नमस्ते सरस्वते देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणी निर्विशेषाय शून्यवादी पाश्यतदेशतारिणी। जयो श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। नमो ब्राह्मण देवाय गो ब्राह्मण हिताय च जगद्धिताय कृष्णाय गोविंदाय ते नमः। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिय। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्रिशे नमः। पांचाकल्पतरूभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितनां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। अनंतकोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। नामाचार्य हरिदास प्रभु जी ठाकुर की जय। श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। हरे कृष्ण। हरे कृष्ण चिल्ड्रन।
हरे कृष्ण
Okay, so let's start with the chapter 2. One second, where is Amrita Mataji has come? Amrita. She's not there. Okay, I'll post once again. Okay, can somebody be co-host who can do, like, you have to post in the chat.
I can be, ma'am.
I want someone elder. Who is above 8th standard, 9th standard? Who is there? 8th.
Mataji, I'm 8th standard.
Mataji, I'm 8th.
Who's 5?
Mataji, I'm 9.
Mataji, I'm 8th.
Yeah, Bhuvana, I'll make. Okay. Yeah. Bhuvana, you will have to keep posting this attendance key. Okay.
Okay, Mataji.
So that because when I'll be in class, I'll not be able to share. Some people join late, na? You know the key, right? I need not share you?
No, Mataji, I know the key.
Okay. So, message to everyone. Sometimes in chat, na, some people, you will get an individual message. Select us to all and then post the key, okay?
Okay, Mataji.
Okay. Okay. So welcome children. So today is the second day of understanding Gita in 18 days. So today's chapter is Sankhya Yoga, which is also called as Contents of Gita Summarized. So what does it mean? So basically, whatever we are going to learn in 18 chapters, this is summarized. Everything is summarized. We have everything in this chapter. But then all the other chapters, we are going to see that in detail. But this chapter almost covers everything about the Gita. So a quick recap, what were the 5 reasons why Arjuna was not ready? Can someone raise the hands? Who can answer? Yes, Sai,
Samrita.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, compassion, yes. No enjoyment.
Yes.
Sin.
Yes.
Family tradition.
Yes.
Indecision.
Very good. So these
Thank
are
you,
the
Mataji.
5 reasons. Okay. So Arjuna gives Krishna that I cannot fight Krishna. And then he gives 5 reasons. So now Krishna is going to answer for everything. Like for each of his query, like what reasons he has given, Krishna is going to answer in this chapter. So this is stage of God realization. So what is God realization means? So understanding, like, what is, how do we realize God? Okay. So there are, for understanding or realizing God, there are three stages. First one is Brahman, second Paramatma, and Bhagavan. So we will see what it is. So Brahman. So this is like, okay, God is there, like Krishna. So his bodily effulgence, the light which comes out of his body, that light is called as Brahman. But many people think, like some people, like 90% in India, people think, not only in India, around the world, usually in West, it is mostly like people think God means some light. Okay, they'll tell, okay, I believe in God, there is some power in this world, but I don't believe that there is a form for God. Okay, that is very wrong, because God has a form, Krishna has a form. So this is a Brahman feature. So this is a partial, like a first realization. That is a realization, but that is a initial realization. So next is the Paramatma. So Paramatma means, he is also called as super soul. So anyone knows where does Paramatma live? Who knows? Yes.
In ourselves.
Where? In which place? You have to tell. Which part of our body?
I'm in our soul.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Our soul.
Okay. One second. I'll unmute when I need. Okay. Okay. You just raise the hands. So not soul means it is in heart. Okay. It's not soul. Like answer is the heart. Paramatma stays in our heart. So in the four-handed form, like this Vishnu form, you can see. So this is the form which is there in our heart. So this is a second realization. This is like yogis and all, they meditate on this form, Paramatma feature, four-handed form. So Bhagavan. So this is Shyam Sundar form, Krishna form. This is a two-handed form of Krishna. So this is a Bhagavan realization. So this is the highest. Okay. So how can we understand this? Like, for example, like you just think, not example, okay, I'll tell you one, like a story, okay. So there is one village. In village, it's like a very remote village. They don't know anything like how train looks like. So once, like everybody comes to know that there is a train going to come. So they're all are excited. They all come to see to the station how the train looks like. So then when the train comes from far, what can you see first? Yes, Hema? What can you see first when the train is coming from far? What can you see first?
Ma'am, we can see the engine.
The light, right? If it is the light, it puts the light. So what happens? It puts the light. And then suddenly what the a set of people, what they think? Oh, I saw the train. And then they're so excited. They run to people and they say, oh, I have seen the train. It looks like a light. Okay, that is what they say. And then the other people are still waiting. And then again, the train comes. So it comes like a zigzag, right? The train moves very zigzag. So what the people think? The train looks like a snake. Okay. And then those set of people, they run again to the village and they say, oh, we know. It is not light. Actually, it is like a snake. The train looks like a snake. And then the devotee of the Lord, you can tell, like they are waiting patiently for the train to arrive, and the train arrives and they enter inside. They see, oh, this train has a compartment. So many compartments are there. It has so many berths. It also has a pantry. And so everything. So this person sees everything in detail properly. So that is the comparison you can remember. So Brahman. So Brahman means the first initial people who ran away by seeing the light. So that is Brahman. So next is Paramatma and Bhagavan. Okay. So this is one more analogy Prabhupada gives. It is like a sun analogy. We can also understand this feature. Like there is sun. So when we see sun, we only can see the light, right? The rays, sun rays you can see. But actually, sun is also a person. So we don't know. Many of us, we don't know that sun is also a person. So Brahman. So sun rays are compared to Brahman. And then Paramatma is sun disk. Okay. And then Bhagavan, where there is a sun god inside the sun planet. So that is called as Bhagavan. So this is a highest realization. So Bhagavan is the highest realization. So who is Bhagavan? So Bhagavan Parashuramani, who is a Parashuramani, is a father of Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva is one who has written all the Vedas and Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita, Mahabharata, everything, right? He is the one who is the author and also the author of Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam. So his father, he has defined Bhagavan as the one who is complete in his all these six opulences. So what are those six opulences? Yes, somebody can read now. Aniket. Yes, what
yes, ma'am. Beauty, yeah. Rich, famous, strength, knowledge. Ma'am, what is the last one?
Renunciation.
Yeah. Ma'am, what does that mean?
I will explain everything now, one by one, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So, Bhagavan is someone who is all beauty. It is not all beauty, all riches, all famous, all strength, all knowledge and all renunciation. So we'll see one by one. So, what is all strength? So you all know what is this pastime? What is this pastime? Yeah, hand raised. Who has not done so far? You know, Reshma, what is, I don't know, what is your name?
Ma'am, my name is Harshan and this is Tanay.
Okay, Harshal and Harshan.
Harsh.
Harsh, okay. Harsh, what is this pastime? You know who is this?
Yeah, holding this is what? Krishna holding a mountain from protecting some thunder god.
Yeah, what is this mountain name?
I don't know.
Yes, Rudransh. What is the name of the mountain? Don't know. It's Govardhan, right?
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Yeah. Yes, go. Yes.
Ma'am, it is Govardhan Parvat.
Yeah, very good. So this is Govardhan Parvat. You know how long it was? It was a 25 kilometer long. Okay. It is a 25 kilometer. And how many days he holded? 7 nights and 7 days. 7 days and 7 nights. That too, in one little finger, Krishna was holding. Okay. Does anyone have so much strength? And then he is doing flute. In another hand, he is doing flute. And he is holding in little finger the mountain. And whole village people were under this. These people are, see, they're like holding sticks because they're like love for Krishna. Na? They think that Krishna is, maybe he is feeling pain. So they're so innocent people. So, but Krishna is so strong. And this is, this pastime, anybody knows? Who is this demon? Yeah, Harsh.
Ma'am, I know only that Krishna is trying to kill a demon that Kansa asked to kill Krishna.
Yeah, that is Putana. Okay, she comes to give poison to Krishna. But he was just an infant, but such a big demon.
Ma'am, she took a form of a beautiful woman and came and took Krishna and become her own form.
Yeah, yes. Okay, so this is a... then again here... This is Rama, right? So Rama wanted to make a bridge, like to bring Sita Mata from Lanka. He wanted to make a bridge. But he prays Samudra Deva to help him in that. But he doesn't listen at all. Like he ignores. So for 3 days, Lord Ramachandra wait. And then he gets angry. Then he warns him that he will dry it up the ocean. So immediately he appears. So that is the strength of the Lord. So Rama and Krishna are same. Okay, there is no difference between Rama and Krishna. And this is Krishna is all beautiful. So you can see this Shyam Sundar from. So though Krishna is told as like, he is like a bluish cloud. I mean, he's compared to the color of a cloud. He's not exactly black. And people, that is why he is called Shyama Sundara. He is also called as black, but he is very beautiful. And so many gopis, they wanted to marry him. And he also married like many queens. They are all like, they were, yeah. So, 16,000 women, right? They wanted to marry Krishna, and because he was so beautiful. And in Brahma Samhita, there is a shloka, like it says, Kandarpa Koti Kamaniya Vishesha Shobham. It is actually full is Venum Kvanantam Aravinda Dalaya Taksham Varha Vatamsam Asitambu Dasundarangam Kandarpa Koti Kamaniya Vishesha Shobham Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. So what does it say? So Krishna's beauty is surpasses beauty of a cupids, millions of cupids. So cupids are considered to be a very beautiful Gandharvas, like, okay, their Manmata. So his beauty surpasses millions of cupids. So that is the prayer of Brahma in Brahma Samhita. So then it comes renunciation. So what is renunciation? So here we can see, like, Krishna, he is a proprietor or the lord of entire universe, not only this universe, like spiritual world. So both, but he is not attached to anything, right? Because every day of Brahma, this world is created, and every night it gets annihilated, because Brahma's year is 311 trillion years. That Brahma lives for 311 trillion years. So how many times we die and we are born, right? So, but Krishna is unattached to anything. Though he is a creator, he is not attached to anything. And here this pastime. So anybody knows what is this pastime here? Can raise your hand. Vaishnavi, you know?
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, so where is he going? Krishna is leaving some place. Which place is he leaving here?
Vrindavan.
Yeah, and where is he going to?
Krishna is leaving Vrindavan and going to, I don't remember the name of that place, Mother.
Okay, no problem. So he's going to Mathura, okay? So this is Akrura comes in to takes him, who takes him, okay? So he is leaving Vrindavan. He was so attached, right? When he was very small, everybody pampered Krishna so much, and everyone in Vrindavan loved Krishna so much. But then when he left, again it is said like he never returned to that place. So that is, that shows like he is not attached. Krishna is happy on his own. He is not like us, like becoming sad sometimes, becoming happy sometimes. He is always happy in himself. He don't want anybody else to make him happy. Okay, he's completely renounced. And this is another, like, okay, who can answer this? Yes, Vishwas.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you are Advait?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Advait, you know what is this instance here, Rama? And who is this?
Rama and...
His father. What is Rama's father name? Okay, you know, when was this? Have you seen Ramayana?
Yes.
Yeah. So Rama is going where? Rama is going where? He's leaving palace and going where?
To forest.
So Rama is going to forest, right? This is Dasharatha. Okay. So Dasharatha, so actually the next day was he was supposed to be crowned as a king. Okay, but then his stepmother, Kaikeyi, does not want Rama to become the king. She wanted her son, Bharata, to be the king. So she will not allow. So she had given a promise to, I mean, two promises she had, which he was supposed to fulfill. She had taken promise from Dashrath. So Dashrath was helpless, so he had to oblige her, and he agrees. So finally, Rama had to leave to forest for 14 years along with Sita Mata and Lakshman. So that time, he never felt I was supposed to become king, and now I didn't get it. So he was completely renounced. He was happy. Even going to forest also, he was very happy he took. So that is the renunciation. So this is all knowledge. Okay. Krishna is all knowledge. So this Bhagavad Gita was spoken 5,000 years back to Arjuna. Okay, actually this is not just then, it was actually told even more before to the sun god, but 120 million years ago. So, but then today also we are discussing about this Bhagavad Gita, right? So Krishna is all knowledge. This is full knowledge. We have every, there is nothing that there is Bhagavad Gita is not having answers for. And also the all Vedas come from the Lord. So this has come from the Lord. So he is a all knowledge. And the world, the spiritual world, whatever creations God has done, right? Everything is complete by itself. Even the small ant, you see, you will be amazed to see one small ant, but it has everything, right? It has in itself everything. So that shows like how amazing is creation of the Lord. It is everything complete by himself, itself. So what is, so that is why there is a shloka in Ishopanishad which says, Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. So he is complete, and whatever emanations comes from the Lord, he is also complete. It is like see, if you have 5 apples and if you give someone 3 apples, only 2 is left, right? But it is not in case of Krishna. He is creating so many universe, and then but he is still the same. He has so much potential that he still remains the same. So he is fully knowledgeable, and Krishna and both the spiritual world and the material world, whatever he has created, that has complete. Like in this world, there is nothing like you have to go to moon and bring it, like, right? If you don't have water, you have to go to moon, nothing like that. So you have everything in this world. So that shows that he's so knowledgeable, Krishna. Okay, this is all riches. So this is again, Krishna is the proprietor of, this is a Krishna where he stays. This is a spiritual world with Radharani, and this is called Goloka. And this is 16,000 princes, right? So for every prince, for it is not like for one person, he all 16,000 were in one palace. Actually, he made 16,000 palaces which were full of jewels, like made of jewels. Such kind of palaces Krishna made for the all his wives. So some people will tell, no, I want to be like Krishna, or people, some are like, oh, I'll marry one more. But people will not be able to manage even one wife. But Krishna manages 16,000 wives with all of them, for all of them palaces also, right? And then this is universe, like 3 worlds. And we are somewhere here. Earth is somewhere here in between, okay? So this I will show in another chapter. I think in chapter 8 it will come. I'll explain in detail there. So this is, we are here, Bhuloka. So there are top planets, okay? When we do pious deeds, we go to the top planets. And when we do bad deeds, we come down. Atala, Vitala, Patala, Tala, Tala, like that. Many planets are there. So this is 14 planetary system, which is Brahma is the head here, Brahmaloka. So all this is Krishna's. So Krishna is all rich. So all famous. So again, Bhagavad Gita is so famous. We are still discussing as on today, right? So it is so famous. So it was told so many years back, yet it is so famous. So Krishna is all famous. And all activities of Krishna's, like so many demons he killed, everything we discuss even today. So he is very famous. And this is a pastime. Anybody remembers what is this pastime? What is Krishna doing there? You put your videos on, okay? Then it is easy for me to unmute whoever hand raised. Otherwise, I'll not be able to. Yeah, Medhavi.
Yes, Mataji. Once Krishnaji swallowed some mud into his mouth, and then Yashoda Maiya opened his mouth to see whether he had swallowed the mud, and Yashoda Maiya saw the whole universe in his mouth.
Yeah, and also she saw herself, okay, and then she fainted, right? So,
yes.
Yeah, so this is the pastime. So all his pastimes are very famous. So everybody remembers that, okay? But you just see, if there, like, there are many people famous in this world, right? But how many, how much we remember? No one remembers. We don't even remember our great grandfathers, right? We may remember hardly like our grandfather. And then if you ask his father name, we don't know, because we no one knows about, like, we because Krishna is so famous. So many years back he said, but then everybody remembers. Okay. This is very famous shloka. You all have to learn this. Okay. Tomorrow you have to tell this shloka. कार्पण्य दोषो पहत स्वभाव रुच्चामि त्वां धर्म सम्मूढचेता यच्छ्रेयस्य निश्चितं ब्रूहि तन्मे शिष्यस्ते अहं शादि मां त्वां प्रपन्नम्. सो ओके क्षीरजा, कैन यू रीड द ट्रांसलेशन?
Now I am confused about my duty. In this condition, I am asking you to tell me clearly what is best for me. Now I am your discipline and a soul surrendered up unto you. Please instruct me.
So now what is happening? So in chapter 1, Arjuna and Krishna, Arjuna was seeing Krishna as his friend. Okay. But now what happens? He is surrendering as a student, like as a disciple, and he is completely surrendering to Krishna because he gave 5 reasons he cannot fight, and now he is very confused. He is saying, please guide me. So now Krishna will talk. So we saw that Krishna never spoke, right? In the chapter 1, Krishna never opened, he didn't even open the mouth. So there is a change of rasa, like from the Sakya it become a Dasya rasa. So it is like he become a, like a student. So he's completely, so we have to be humble. Okay. When we want to learn something, we should have that humility in us. Otherwise we will not be able to learn anything. So when we are, even when we are learning to Bhagavad Gita, we should have that humility and we should accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord. So only then we will be able to understand the knowledge, right? So let's see now what Krishna will have to tell. So he's asking, what is right for me? So basically what Arjuna is asking, is it right for me to fight, or should I give up everything, or I have to take the sannyas? I have to go to forest. Let me go to forest. Instead of killing everyone, there is no enjoyment, it is sin. I better go to forest and meditate. So that is what Arjuna is thinking. It is better. Okay. So please tell me what is good for me, he's asking. Okay, so now Krishna is answering one by one. So this is answer for the compassion. Okay, so you are not what you think you are. What does it mean? Anyone can answer? Please put on your videos and then raise your hand. Otherwise, I'll not be able to unmute. Yes, Rudransh.
Yes, Mataji.
So what is it meaning? You are not what you think you are. What is it meaning? What are you?
Mataji, it means, ma'am,
yes, you don't know,
Mataji. This is thoda network issue ho gaya, Mataji. Iska matlab hai ki tum wo nahi ho jo tum soch rahe ho.
So what are you then? What is it meaning? Okay, if I tell, okay, Rudransh, you are not what you are, like what I see you are. You are not that. So what does it mean? What does it mean?
Mataji, it means I am not me, and you are saying that I am not me.
Yeah, so what are you? Okay, we'll ask someone else. Yes, Riddhi, you know the answer?
We are souls.
Yeah, very good. So what are we? We are spirit souls. Okay, so what is this? Who am I? Am I this body? Am I this eyebrow, this hair, eye, air, ear, mouth, hand, knee, leg, right? This is, every one of us has. But are we this? Are we just this body? Are we a bunch of chemicals? Are we made of just a chemicals? Means this is made of Pancha Mahabhuta, right? Our body is made of 5 elements. Earth, water, fire, air and ether. So, yeah. So So these are the Pancha Mahabhutas. So are we just this body? Am I just this body? And then now I have got some name, right? So these are living and non-living. So how can we differentiate between a living thing and a non-living thing? So living things, basically we can classify as the people, animals, and plants. They are all living. How can you differentiate? And non-living thing is natural. There, some are natural. This is like mountains. And then man-made or houses. So how do you differentiate this? Yes, Aniket.
Ma'am, like man-made and man-made are non-living things, and natural is also non-living things. But people, animals, and plants are living things.
So who made that? So who made that?
Ma'am, God made that.
Yeah. So they are living. What is the difference, though? What does it mean? There is a life in it, right? There is a life. So when there is a life, it is called as living thing. There is no life here, so it is non-living. Because every here, it has a soul here. Okay? There is soul present in even people, animal, and the plants, but not in the man-made things. So this is the first lesson of the Bhagavad Gita, most important lesson. And this is the basic thing which we are supposed to learn. So we are not this body. So what is this example shows? Car and the driver, okay? We have a car. So car is compared to like a car and the driver is the soul, right? So this, if there is no driver, I mean, there is no value for that car, right? Like you can, so there is that example, 1 second. Oh, okay. Okay. So basically somebody is there who is driving. So example is our body is like a car. Okay. And the driver is the soul. The soul is driving us. Okay. These are all actually dead material, the whatever. So if the soul is not instructing, and then we can't do anything. So there is soul in us, which is heading like a driver. So what will happen? So if there is if the car, something happens to the car, what will happen? The driver will not happen. For driver, nothing. I mean, driver can also still be there. And then he can change the car, right? So similarly, we also, if something happens to body, the person will leave the soul will go and takes a next body. So we'll see that. So where is the soul situated? In the heart. So bird in the cage. So this is a beautiful example. Like most of us, all of us are doing like this now, right now. Because see, this is a cage is compared to our body. And this is a soul. Soul is compared to this parrot. So this lady, old lady, you can see, what is she doing? She's painting so nicely with color, very beautiful colors. And every day she changes the colors and everything. But she is not at all seeing the bird. She is not giving food to the bird. Okay. How many days the bird can live? Yes. Advait?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. If you're not giving any food to the bird, can the bird live for a long time?
No.
Yeah. What will happen to the bird?
It will die.
Yeah. So it will die. So we are also, what we are doing right now, we are so much concerned about bodily comforts, right? We are doing so much, we are getting so much, we are doing comforts for our, like we are only thinking about fulfilling our stomach and taking care of our body and all these things. Like this is basically, we are not feeding anything to the soul, okay? Our soul is crying there, okay, give me some food. But we are not bothered. We are not even talking to the soul. We are not bothered. We are just involved in taking care of our body. So that is what is the comparison here. So what is the food for the soul? Okay, we all will chant together now. Okay, this is the food for the soul. So where are you all? What am I doing? Sorry. See. One second. What am I doing? Okay. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, you are able to unmute now?
Yes.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, together along with me.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay.
Yep.
Hare,
yes,
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare
Krishna.
Hare
Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Hare Krishna.
Hare Rama. Hare Rama.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, thank you. So this is a food for our soul. Okay, so every day if we do that, then slowly what our soul also will get some food. So this is the food for the soul. We have to every day chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So this Hare Krishna Mahamantra is given by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this in detail you will come to know in the, I think in further chapters I will explain you. He is Krishna himself who came 500 years back, and it is mentioned in many scriptures, and this very secret incarnation of Krishna, and it is mentioned in many scriptures as well. So everything I'll be showing you in future, in the coming classes. So we are spirit souls, jivatma, okay, body and the soul. So this is also an important shloka. देहिनोस्मिन् यथा देहे कौमारं यौवनं जरा तथा देहांतर प्राप्तिर् धीरस्तत्र नमुह्यति. So you can see like how the soul, it's the same soul, right? He is a small infant baby, and then it becomes a small boy and a bigger boy, and then a man, right? And then like a youth, so he comes to middle age, and this is a man, and then old age. Like that's how he goes from one. We change our bodies, but it is the same soul which is going through all. Like we tell, right? Oh, when I was small, I was like this. So who is that? I am the soul. The soul is the same. Soul is the same, but it is changing the body. Body is changing. And finally, when it becomes very old, it dies. I mean, it dies in the sense it leaves the body. The soul leaves the body and takes a new body. Okay. One of you read? Yes, Sheetal, can you read?
As the embodied soul continually passes in this body from boyhood to the young old age, the soul similarly passes into another body at death. The self-realized soul in between, in not bewildered by such a change.
Yeah. So what is Krishna telling here in this shloka? So when we are all like embodied, means like we have this what we have, material made of five elements, right? So this soul is actually covered. Basically, we are covered with all these material elements. So that is what is called as embodied soul. So this embodied soul The soul is passing continuously from one body to another. We don't remember, but we have been taking from many births we have taken. We don't remember that. So the soul is taking, just like how from boyhood to youth to old age. Similarly, soul is passing from, when it dies, it takes, goes to the another body. So the self-realized soul. So self-realized means one who has understood this science will not be bewildered. If something death happens, they will not be crying, because they know, okay, it is just the soul leaving the body, because body has become old. It had to leave one day, right? So it is leaving. So he will not get bewildered. He will take, accept everything. Okay, let the person, okay, he's leaving. Okay, then we will, anyways, the soul is, there is no death for the soul. The soul is going to another body. So this you can see in this picture also, how the soul is changing the body in the sense, we are like from the infant, how we are, our body is changing, and then finally we die, and then the soul leaves, right? Soul takes another body. So see how, just like a changing dress, so the soul is changing the body. Like how we change the dress when it becomes very old, what we do? We just throw the dress and use a new one, right? Just like that. The soul gives up the old and bodies, and then it takes a new one. So this is a life cycle. So from infant to a little boy, and then this is a like school going, like you are like now in this age somewhere, and then this is a grown up adult, and then he become a middle aged person, and then become very old, and then finally the person leaves the body. Okay, all of you had this when you were small, you used to have a tricycle, right? Yeah. And then you had a two cycle also. I think now you have a bicycle, right? You all many have. Vaishnavi, you have bicycle with you?
Yes, Mataji, I do have.
And you had a small one also when you were infant?
Yeah, when I was little, I had a tricycle. Now yeah. I have the second type of cycle.
Yeah, right. And then what we do? Like when we grow up and we our demands will change. Our needs are changed. Needs will change. So when we have to go to college or something, you will ask your dad, right, to let me have a two-wheeler, right? I need it. So, and then when you start earning yourself, you will want to buy a car, right? And then,
yes, Mataji.
Yeah. So something happens to the car. What will we do? We just change the car, right? So similarly, the body... the soul just changes the body, that is outside thing, but nothing will happen to the soul. So this is a 84 lakh species. Okay, this is given in Padma Purana also. So there are 84, God has created 84 lakh species of life. Why God has created so many lives? Because of our, based on our desires. Okay, everybody has their own desire. Like some people wish to be like a tiger, they like, or some want to become like a bird and be free, and like that is their thing. Like whatever somebody thinks at the time of death, that is the body he is going to get, and based on his karma also. So this is basically this, we have taken from sea, water bodies, to then different animals we have taken, and finally we have got the human body. So there is no guarantee that we will not get again animal life. And again, if we do bad karmas, we can again go back to the lower species. But when we do devotional service, when we pray God, so we will not go back at least to the animal life. We will at least go to a next also, we will get a human life. So that is Krishna guarantees. And we can see this is what we have further shlokas where Krishna will confirm that. So this is a human cycle. So this is a birth. So this is what generally like everyone offers, right? So teenager, he's working and he is playing guitar and all this, like when he becomes a teenager, and then his demands change. He wants to have a family, he gets married and then children, and then it's his profession and then maturity. So he has become a bit old, and then finally the seniority, he becomes very old, and then finally the person dies. So every one of us have to go through this. No one is permanent. Matra sparshastu kaunteya shitoshna sukha dukkha agama payino nitya tamstitikshasva bharata. Yes, Piyush, can you read the translation? Okay, Riddhi, can you read?
Yes, Mataji. O son of Kunti, the non-permanent appearance of happiness and distress and their disappearance in due course are like the appearance and disappearance of winter and summer season.
Yeah. So Krishna is telling Arjuna that whatever this happiness and distress, it is like a seasons, right? Seasons, no season will stay for a long time, right? So now we are in winter. So before that we had rainy season, and before that we had summer season, right? The seasons are changing. Just like that, the happiness comes in our life and the distress, the problems, or we are sometimes unhappy. So these things are very common. Krishna is telling these are not permanent. Okay. So you have to bear. Okay. We have to, just like how we tolerate, we have to tolerate it. So Krishna is telling that to Arjuna. So you should not get why the day is like that. Some days are very good, right? You feel so good to go to school. Some days you feel very lazy and you want to be like, you feel like not going to school, right? So these are like, it happens to everyone, but we should not get, you should not feel distressed for that. So any problems we get or any in life, we should not get distracted. Just like a seasons, we have to tolerate. So these are the different seasons. So some in, we can see like there is a greenery, and then in autumn there is no, like all the leaves dry up, right? So just like that, how seasons change. So sometimes we are happy, sometimes we are sad. Na jayate mriyate va kadachin nayam bhutva bhavitavana bhuyaha अजो नित्याशाश्वतोयं पुराणो न हन्यते हन्यमाने शरीरे. यस रुद्रांश कैन रीड.
जी माता जी. फॉर द सोल देयर इज नेदर बर्थ नॉर डेथ. एट एनी टाइम ही इज अनबॉर्न इंटरनल एवर एग्जिस्टिंग सच्चिदानंद eternal, full of knowledge, bliss.
Yeah. So Krishna is telling here, the soul can never die. See, Arjuna was very compassionate, right? How can I kill for those people? So they are all my relatives, my teachers. Because why he was compassionate? Because they are all his blood relations, his family people. So that is why he got so emotional. So Krishna is telling here, what are you being emotional for? This body never dies. The soul does not never die. So it is only the body dying. Why are you worrying so much? The soul will always be there, right? So Krishna is telling here, the soul is neither have a birth nor death. It is eternal. What do you mean by eternal means? It is like always existing. There is nowhere in the Shastras that such and such a time the soul came into existence. It is always there. And it is eternal and everlasting. What does it mean? Like Krishna, we are also always Satchit Ananda. That is like eternal, full of knowledge and bliss. Actually, our nature of the soul is always to be happy. But why we are unhappy? Because I am thinking I am this body, right? And then I am thinking whatever problems I get to this body is my problem. And I'm associating with the that problems. That is why I'm feeling like I'm not happy. I'm like, so it is not like that. So the soul, when we do this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, right? So you connect with the Lord. So then you will not feel that unhappiness. You will experience this when you start chanting. So you have to all start chanting. So, Vasam Shijinani Yatha Vihaya Na Anyani Grinnati Naro Parani Tata Sharirani Vihaya Chirnani Anyani Samyati Navani Dehe. Okay. So just like how we are changing the cloths, right? So just like when a old cloth is torn and it has become very old, we change the dress. Or when we become dirty, right? What will we do? What will we do? Yes, Pranshu? When you...
And we change our clothes.
Yeah, so you'll take a bath and then you change the new clothes, right? So just like that, the soul will change. When it becomes body, become old and useless, it just changes. Right? When we when it become dirty, we change the shirt. Just like that. Okay. Yes, Divit, can you read?
As a person puts on new garments, giving up old ones, the soul similarly accepts new material bodies, giving up the old and useless ones.
Yeah. So what is it? You know who is this person? Anybody know who is this person? Yeah, Divit.
Justin Bieber.
Yeah, he's a famous singer, right? So, Justin Bieber. So, you think like he has fallen in water. So, whom will you save? You will save his coat or you will save the person? Yes?
Ma'am, the person.
Yeah, so we are not worried about the outer garment, right? So, similarly, we have to concentrate our... concentration, like main, we have to focus on the satisfying of the soul, not on the body. Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavakaha, na chainam kleda yantyapo, na shoshayati marutaha. Yes, Lava, can you read?
The soul can never be cut into pieces by any weapon, nor can he be burned by fire, nor moistened by water, nor withered by the wind.
Yeah, so no weapons in the world can cut the soul. Okay, you know how big is the soul? So soul is so tiny. I mean, not even a microscope can make out the soul size, because soul is a size like 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. Okay, so small, so tiny. So it cannot be cut. Still, it cannot be cut into pieces. It cannot be burned by fire. Fire cannot burn the soul, and water cannot moisten it, nor the wind can dry it up. So nothing can happen to the soul. So see, this is soul is going. Okay, soul, nothing will happen. So body is there, but when a person dies, only he leaves the body. O son of Kunti, either you will be killed on the battlefield and attain the heavenly planet, or you will conquer and enjoy the earthly kingdom. Therefore, get up and fight with determination. So Krishna is telling, so because he gave the reason as no enjoyment, right? So Krishna is telling why you cannot enjoy, Arjuna. So if you kill, if you get killed in the war, suppose you die. So you can go to a heavenly planet. You can go to Swarga, right? So, or any heavenly planets. Or you can, if you If you win, you can get the whole earth kingdom is yours. So please get up and fight. Because it's a duty of Kshatriya to fight. He cannot give up like that. So Krishna is ordering here, get up and fight. So here this is a heavenly planets on the top, we can see. And here it is, you will be the owning the world. You will be king of the world. Okay. Yes, Rajesh, can you read?
Your enemies will describe you in many unkind words and scroll you a bull. What could you be more painful for you?
Yeah. So Krishna is asking, okay, Arjuna, I can understand that you are so compassionate, you are feeling sad for your that you don't want to kill, but I can accept. But how about your enemies in the opposite team, right? The Duryodhana and those people, what will they think? Oh my God, Arjuna is so coward. He's afraid by seeing our army, right? People will make fun. Tomorrow, what example are you going to set? So Krishna is telling, like, what I think for a Kshatriya, the infame is like a equal to death, right? So Krishna is telling that. So Neha Bhikrama Nashosti Pratyavayona Vidyate Svalpamapyasya Dharmasya Trayate Mahatobayat. So this is again a famous shloka. So what is this shloka saying? That there is no, okay, in this endeavor, there is no loss and little advancement on this path can protect one from the most dangerous type of fear. Okay, so this is a story of one rat. Okay, so this rat, it was like very fond of the cherry, right? Once what happens, it sees in a puja room, there is a lamp and he sees it's burning and it thinks, okay, it must be a cherry. And then it goes and jumps on it. So what will happen? The oil fell on it, spills on the rat and then it dies. Okay, it dies. But what will happen? The Krishna, the Lord thinks that, oh, this has come to do aarti for me. So, and then he gives him the liberation. So liberation means he will not, he will go to the God's world. So that is what Krishna, what is it says? When we do little devotion, that too without knowing it, but still it can protect from most dangerous type of fear. What is the most dangerous type of fear is to become an animal in next life. Okay. So when, if we don't do any devotion service, then there is a chance like we will be becoming an animal in the next life. So we know this story of a squirrel, which also bought us tiny stones for making the bridge, right? So Krishna, Rama delivered the squirrel. So this is Hanuman. So Hanuman burnt Lanka, but for whom he did? He did for Rama. So there is no sin. So in devotion service, when you do it for the Lord, there is no sin. So that is what is the, because Arjuna was giving that it is sinful, right? So what is the Kali Yuga Dharma? So in Kali Yuga, it is said like chanting the holy name. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama Eva Kevalam, Kalau Nasti Eva Nasti, Eva Nasti Gatir Anyata. So three times it is said like, there is no other way than chanting the holy name. And also Krishna has told in chapter 10, Krishna says, Yagna Nam Japa Yagnosmi. In the sacrifice, I am the Japa Yagna. So this is the chanting beads that you get when you buy the book, that Bhagavad Gita book when you buy, right? You get this chanting bead free along with the bag. So buy one copy for yourself. So in Netherlands, right? So there is a law that Bhagavad Gita has to be a part of their curriculum, right? So how lucky they are. And we are born in India, we have this Sanatana Dharma in our country, but in our schools, we don't have this to study, right? So So it was so nice if we all had, maybe we would, it is so nice, like they are all having that access to it from the school days, but we all know, don't have, like, right? Okay, this is an activity. You all put on your videos and you have to repeat along with me. We are not this body. So we are not this body. Do like this. We are not this body. We are spirit souls. Soul is situated in the heart. We cannot see the soul. Okay. And what is the size of the soul? It is the tip of the hair, right? This is the tip of a hair. 1/10,000 part. When you make, we can't even imagine. The tip of a hair is so small, and if you have further 10,000 cut, right? 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair, that is the size of the soul. So these are the properties of the soul. So this is a property of the soul, 1/10,000 size. So please repeat, we are not this. Okay, I'll unmute you all. We are not this.
Body.
We are not this body.
You can do with the action. I don't want just reading. You have to do with the action. We are not this body.
We are not this body. We are spiritual soul.
Soul is situated in the heart.
Soul is situated in the heart.
We cannot see the soul.
We cannot see the soul.
It is 10,000.
1/10,000.
Tomorrow I will ask this. Everybody should remember. Okay. So we are not this body, we are spirit souls. The soul moves from one body to another. Any small service to Krishna. Sorry, this is a takeaway message for today. So what is this? We are not this body. We are spirit souls. The soul moves from one body to another. Any small service done to Krishna is never lost. So we all will chant together now, Hare Krishna. Yes. Yes. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna,
Krishna,
Krishna,
Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Hare Rama,
Rama Rama,
Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare
Hare,
Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Rama Rama.
Okay, thank you, children. So hope you all like the today's class, and please mark your attendance today, and anyone have not done, please do it now. I'll post once again. Bhuvana is posting. Okay, Bhuvana is posting already. Bhuvana, can you post once again?
Okay, Mataji.
Please, every one of you stay here, complete your registration when question and answer session is going on. And then you can leave the class, because you have to complete this before 12. Okay. So anyone has questions, we can take now.